Okay, we're going to go over the basic meaning of how to evaluate with exponents. So here are some examples. 5 squared means 5 times 5. The exponent tells you how many 5s are multiplied together. So 5 is called the base, and 2 is called the exponent. So this would be 25. For the next one, 6 cubed then, the base is 6, so I would have 6 times 6 times 6, which is 216. 3 to the 4th, you would have 4 factors of the base of 3, so 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. Now, by the way I do this is I multiply the first 2 3's together, which is 9, the second 2 3's together, which is 9, and then 9 times 9 is 81. And 2 cubed then would be 2 times 2 times 2, or 8. So in general, if you have a b to the n, the b is called the base, and n is the exponent, and you're multiplying b times itself a bunch of times, and you're going to have n factors of b. So for instance, if I'm going to circle each of the bases up here, 5 is the base, 6 is the base, 3 is the base, 2 is the base. So the base is b. The other number, the exponent, tells you how many of those are multiplied together. So the exponent for each of these I'm circling . So for instance, for the first one, 5 squared, when I say n factors of b, I mean 2 factors of 5. Okay? Factors means the things being multiplied together. Oh, okay, here are some more. Now notice I have a negative 8 in parentheses squared. The reason you have to put the negative 8 in parentheses is to just show that the base is negative 8. So this would mean, since the base is negative 8, this would mean negative 8 times negative 8. Now a negative times a negative is positive, so this is positive 64. Now you don't have to write parentheses around each negative number. If you want, you could write negative 5 times negative 5 times negative 5. You're going to have 3 factors of negative 5. So that's negative, because you've got 3 negative signs, and then 5 times 5 times 5 is 125. Here the base is negative 2. The only way to show that it's negative 2 is to put that negative 2 in parentheses. So we have negative 2. I'm going to use parentheses again. It's up to you which way you want to write this. So I'm going to think of that as a 4 times a 4. Do you see how I'm doing that? 4 times 4, that's going to be 16. Okay, so in this case, it's important to notice if you have a parentheses around a number raised to some exponent, then whatever's in parentheses is the base. So it's important to recognize the base. So here comes the tricky ones. All right, now notice I've got a minus sign, a 9 squared. This is very important to notice. If there is no parentheses around the negative sign is not being squared. So the base in negative 9 squared is not negative 9. This is not negative 9 times negative 9. I'm going to circle the base. The base is just 9. And the base in this second one is just 10. As opposed to the previous problem up here, the base is the whole thing negative 2, because it is in parentheses. All right, so what do we do with that minus sign? Well, you could think of this as the opposite of 9 squared. That works. Or I'm going to suggest if the minus sign is not in parentheses, so that is not being squared, you think of that as a negative 1 times, and then 9 squared is 9 times 9. So now I've got negative 81. This is a real source of confusion for people. A lot of times they'll write negative 9 times negative 9, and that's incorrect. For the second one, again, 10 is the base. So also, I've got negative 1 times 10 times 10, and the answer is negative 1. I'm sorry, another factor of 10. So I'm going to have negative 1,000. All right, let's look at this. What about if it was the negative 9 in parentheses squared? That's different than this problem where the minus sign is not in parentheses. This time, you've got a negative 9 in parentheses. That's to make sure you understand that is the base. So that would be negative 9 times a negative 9, which is positive 81. So you can see quite the difference between the two right here. Notice they mean different things and their answers are different. Sometimes two things that mean something different do come up with the same answer though. Consider these two. In the first one, the base is negative 2, and I need to have three factors of negative 2. So that's negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2, which is negative 8. Now, in the second one, what's the base? The base in the second one is just 2, it's not negative 2. So this means negative 1 times 2 times 2 times 2. Both of them happen to simplify to be negative 8, but they mean something very different. What you need to do is work on writing out what they mean. In other words, this middle step here, writing either negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 for the first one, or negative 1 times 2 times 2 times 2 for the second one. They both happen to simplify to negative 8, but the reason the answer is negative 8 is not the same for each. Now, I did mention that you don't have to write negative 1 times 2 times 2. Another way to think of this is as the opposite of 2 cubed. So that is the opposite. You just write your minus sign, and then you could write 2 times 2 times 2, and that's a negative 8. So keep in mind there's two ways of writing this problem. And the meaning. One is thinking of this minus sign as a negative 1 times 2 cubed, which is 2 times 2 times 2. And the other way is thinking of this as the opposite of 2 cubed, which is the opposite of, and then parentheses, 2 times 2 times 2 is negative 8. Let's just do a couple more. What would 2 to the first power be? That means you only have one factor of 2, so it's 2. Similarly, 7 to the first power would just be 7, one factor of 7. How about 1 squared? 1 times 1. That's still going to be 1. Doesn't matter how many 1s you have. When you keep multiplying by themselves, you're going to keep getting an answer of 1. So by the way, 1 to any power is going to be 1. All right, negative 1 squared. All right, the base here is negative 1. So I have a negative 1 times a negative 1, which is 1. And the last one, I'm going to have 7 negative 1s. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of them. So I've got 7 negative signs, so the answer is going to be negative. But when I keep multiplying by 1 times itself over and over again, I'm going to get 1. Let's do one more. How about negative 1 to the 20th? What do you think? Well, first of all, I want you to think about, is the base 1 or is it negative 1? Okay, hopefully you've got that the base is 1. So this minus sign out in front is a negative 1. And then I'm going to have 1 to the 20th. Now, hopefully you realize you don't have to write that 1 out 29 times, because I just showed you this little rule here. Anything 1 to any power is 1. So that's going to be negative 1 times 1. So the answer is also negative 1. Okay, I want you to put this on pause and try these 8 problems, and then come back and check. Okay, check your answers. See if you came up with the same steps and the same meaning and the correct answers. And very important to keep practicing these. Have fun!